Yeah, I can hear you. Yeah.
Okay, well,
broadband. No, I'm running over broadband.
Let's get started then. Thanks everyone for coming by and taking some time out of your day to listen to our webinar on winning solutions for your flat roof racking projects. It's something we've wanted to do for a while, and mainly because I think it's a really important subject. A lot of people are spending a lot of time getting in quotes for every single last flat roof rack, flat roof project they're bidding on, and it's very time consuming. And we wanted to address how we can all save some money and choosing the right solution at the same time for a variety of reasons. So it's like a one size fits all approach. Yeah, so let's get started and talk a little bit about Frankensolar. If you can go to the next slide, Michelle. So Frankensolar, I'm just going to quickly go through this. Be about 5 minutes going about Frankensolar and why Frankensolar, then 5 minutes about Polar, and then Vishal will take over, and he's got about 20 to 30 minutes on Polar PRG, and then we'll have some time at the end for some questions. So Frankensolar, we were established in 1990 in Germany, in Bavaria actually, in the Franken region. So that's where we've come from. Since 2011, we are in North America with our headquarters in Brampton, Ontario. We've also got a location in Toronto, in Edmonton. We've done over 10,000 residential and commercial systems where we've supplied equipment to in Canada. And currently we have about 15 full-time employees. Can you go to the next one, Vishal? Thank you. Our mission statement is quickly what we're about. So assisting Canadian solar installers with designing high quality and competitively priced solar projects for every home and commercial building in Canada. That's really what we are in a nutshell. We're trying to help installers it's not quite like everyone else where we just fulfill orders. We really try to help all of you designing systems that are economical while at the same time using good quality products, because it's our opinion, and to move our industry forward, projects have to be reliable, but the cost of solar is really important as well. So what makes Frankensolar different from some of the other distributors out there? I guess the first one, we all kind of have, but we've got relationships with pretty much every major supplier of solar equipment. We carry all major inverter companies, a variety of the panels as well. Most of the big brands are on there, and on the racking side, we've got a number of options for you as well. We have in-house electrical engineering support with Alexander Wolf. So for those of you that have talked to him or met him, he's super asset for any solar installer out there. He's great at helping with pretty much anything solar related when it comes to the design side of things. We also have a price list. I think we're actually the first solar distributor in Canada that had a price list, and we have one price list that for everyone. So for all the solar installers, they all get the same price list. It's all very black and white, so there are no games played here. Everyone gets a really good price right off the bat. There are a couple of discounts on there, but it's all black and white. So for example, if you have an order over $5,000, you get free shipping, and everyone gets that. And so that's how we do things. Now to the reason of the webinar. Obviously, a lot of people have flat roof systems where they need quotes for. And what we have asked ourselves, or our goal was to find a to find a solution that is really easy to quote. At the same time, it's got to be really high quality and cost effective. And what we came up with is the PRG, which is on the next slide, Michelle. So Polar's PRG, it is a modular design, and Michelle will get into details of all of this stuff, but it's a modular design which allows us to have a per panel pricing. So on our price list, if you get it, if you don't, you should ask us for it. But it is a, you know, everyone has a per panel price on there. And it is, it's something you can use to quote for your RFPs that you're bidding on, or if you're quoting a commercial system of some sort. It's really black and white, and it's easy to quote because it's always costing the same. At the same time, it's got to be low ballast, right? And this is a low ballast solution because you want to have confidence that you can actually install the system once you win the system. And the PRG is probably one of the lower weight solutions out there, lower ballast solutions out there. Generally, it's between 2 to 5 pounds per square foot. So it's very low weight. It allows for green zone clamping, which is really nice because a lot of the other products out there don't allow that, don't have that. And it's really important because panel manufacturers will not honor warranties if you're clamping panels outside of the green zones and you have defects. And then the last and very important aspect of it is that it's got to be very attractive from a price standpoint. And the price is well below $60 a panel. And you can see the exact price on the price list, but it's very, very well priced. So without any further ado, I'd like to pass it on to Vishal to take it from here.
Okay, yeah, thank you, Danny, for that introduction. And I'll take, like Danny said, a little bit of time to tell you a little bit about Polar and more about PRG, but try to keep enough time in the end so we can ask questions. I have with me Keith Roy, who is the head of our technical services division. He's been on numerous PRG and installs and PRU installs, and many of you may have met him on sites. And I have Pal Sadiapam, who's our director of engineering here, who is largely responsible for the design of the product and who just completed the huge process of getting everything UL certified in Canada and the US. So we're here to answer, you know, technical field related questions about Polar at the end. So don't be shy. If you do have questions, just so you guys know, there is a chat feature that you should see on your screen. So you can ask questions as we go, and we'll so, you know, if something comes to mind, write it down as it's going through, and we'll read them at the end, and we can start with questions on chat, and then have some of you raise your hands to ask the questions out loud when we're there. So so I'll jump into a little bit about Polar Racking. Polar Racking is a Canadian company. We're founded here in Ontario, originally in Windsor, Ontario, really to address the flat roof ballasted market. Quickly, you know, we jumped out and took a big lead in the flat roof ballasted space, working on some of the larger portfolios in Ontario, most notably TDSB, Ottawa Carleton District School Board, Waterloo, York, Simcoe, many of the Home Depots, Canadian Tires, and then just commercial buildings in general, and that was with our PR1 and PR2 product. Since then, we've moved into, you know, flush mount and ground mount, which and carport, which we'll show you afterwards. We are shipping all over the U.S., Canada, and the Caribbean right now through most of our product lines. We have over 300 megawatts of products sold, which is very exciting for a Canadian company that, you know, largely focused on rooftop. Our goal, similar to Frankensolar, is to develop innovative racking solutions that enable our clients to build systems at the lowest possible installed cost. And if you've worked with us and you've seen how our products go together, you'll understand that. So, just in terms of the products themselves, PRG, which is a flat rooftop solution, which there's many slides about that, and you know, I won't get into that too much right now, but we'll go into that more detail later on. Flat roof ballasted solution. PRR is our flush mount solution. Great for residential, even more on commercial side. We're, you know, super competitive on the commercial jobs. PRUD, which is our small ground mount solution. It's in stock at Frankensolar right now. If you have a small ground mount, you know, less than 500 kilowatts, it's very, very easy to go and pick up stock at Frankensolar. It's a pre-engineered system, you know, a over-engineered system, if you want to call it. A beefy design where you could put literally 1 2x8 table on its own, or 10 2x8 tables, and they all stand a pretty strong pre-stamped table and pre-stamped engineering for foundation. And PRU, which is our utility scale ground mount, typically for projects 500 kilowatts and below and above. I'm sorry, you know, with the larger sizes, we can get a lot more custom in your design and in your foundation, and be much more competitive in that way. Also, typically project sizes are bigger, and we can take advantage of, you know, different wind zones to help optimize the rack and reduce the cost. So something new to the lineup is carports. So we recently acquired a company in the US, and we've added their product line to ours. They already have 25 megawatts installed in the US. Beautiful carport systems, and we're having a lot of success this year in terms of adding to that, mostly in U.S. projects, but we're starting to see a lot of uptake in Canada as well. And we also, on the ground mount side, we make our own helical piles, ground screws from overseas, and driven piles. So either round post or I-beam, we supply a lot of that for ground mount installations. On the engineering side, we have the large engineering team, mostly geotechnical engineers. We have 6 geotechnical engineers with about 2 gigawatts worth of foundation experience, civil experience, and we have in-house structural design as well. So, you know, just something for you to keep in mind. We can offer, you know, survey services also. So if you are looking for that, for surveys for rooftop or for ground mount, we offer that service as well. And contact Frankensolar when you're ready to discuss that. So PRG, again, some of the highlights that he had mentioned, you know, very low PSF, and we'll get into that because it is a grid-based system. It's not a foot-based system, so it's completely interconnected. There's a lot of load sharing there. And oftentimes, if you have a nice-sized project, you have many, many modules in the center of the array that have no ballast at all, so that allows you to keep the weight down. It is a modular design, so for the most part, you can pick up a module. You know, if you hit something on, you know, a drain or something like that, you can move that module over, and there's much impact to your design. Completely integrated bonding. And I'll show you that a little bit more. Again, less ballast stones and less locations. UL certified for Canada and the US, and a very low cost per watt. We offer it at 5 to 15 degrees. The panels are in landscape. It is made out of galvanized steel tube, and it works on we have an option for 60 and 72 cell modules. The other great thing about it, it's very quick assembly. Basically, you need, you know, one driver to install the entire rack, and then a second socket basically to just put the wind deflectors on. So very, very, very quick. Again, here, multiple spacing options depending on where you are, how much space you have. You know, you're going to tell us ahead of time which one you want. Typically in Canada, we sell the 10 degrees tighter. In the US, we sell mostly 5 degree tighter. And again, you know, they're just lower latitude. So that's why, and everybody wants to have a lot of density. The one thing to point out here is we do have a 15 degree option. So if you do have the space on the roof and you want to get some more production out of your modules, that option is definitely available to you. And and I think, you know, contact Frankensolar for pricing on that one. I don't think it's on their price list, but you know, that option's available if you need it. So so now I'm just going to talk a little bit about the product and you know, what we need from you when we're designing the product. So when we are looking to do a layout for you, so you know, obviously Polar will, you know, you can get a quote from Frankensolar anytime, and Polar will provide a free layout for you for your project. And there is, you know, an intake form that you can get from Frankensolar and, you know, to provide the details. But the details that we're looking for are, you know, desired project size. You know, sometimes you have a huge roof, but you only want to put, you know, 200 kilowatts. Sometimes the desired project size is max out the roof. So that's the type of information we need. The module data, the data sheet and dimensions, the tilt angle, so 5, 10, or 15 degrees, the intro spacing, the tighter or the standard spacing like you saw in the previous slide. Generally, the roof layout. So obviously, if you have a CAD survey of the roof, that's the ideal scenario. That's more of a dream for us than the standard, unfortunately. But you know, if not, you know, an address to get started. We'll, you know, at the very min, we'll do some Google Earth images and we'll get you a layout. Obviously, before you build, you know, we advise you to confirm, you know, the height and the sizes of the obstructions on the roof. We need the building height and the parapet height. That's very, very important when we're ballasting your racking, because the building height and the parapet height both have a big impact on the wind zones. Also, if you know your roof can hold a certain amount of weight, please let us know up front. You know, we'll work with you and come up with different solutions to be able to, you know, hit your ballast requirement and any special requirements that you have for your project. Obviously, each jurisdiction is different. You know, for the most part, you know, it's the same. But if you know of any special requirements that you have, you know, the more information you give us up front, the better on that. So this is what you'll generally receive from Polar when we do a layout for you for PRG. It'll be your buildings along with a bill of material here. And then within, so you'll get an idea of the total number of kilowatts, the total number of modules, and the amount of ballast that you're going to need, you know, is the next step after, you know, we've approved the layout and we're moving forward. Typically, you know, this is what you'll get when you see your layout. You'll see, you know, this is how many modules I have on there, you know, the placement, the corners, and how many stones you need in each bay. Again, the advantage of the PRG rack over most of the other racks on the system, on the market right now, is that PRG is a completely interconnected grid. And I'll show you some more pictures of that also. And what does that mean? That means, like, if you lift this core, you know, one corner of the array, you know, technically it acts as a, you know, combined unit. So you need a lot less ballast than you would definitely get on a foot-based system. Plus we have a wind deflector behind each module, which further reduces your ballast. You can even see here on this roof, you have a lot of bays with zero ballast. And again, the bigger the subarray, the more bays you have in the center with zero ballast. So, you know, starting at a 6x6, after that, you should start to see a lot of 0, 0, 0 bays, which, you know, from the fact that it's lighter on the roof, you know, it helps from it lighter on the roof, less stones, you know, to buy and less stones to carry around the roof. And Keith, and I'm sure a lot of the installers can attest that, you know, carrying around the stones is a big pain. The other thing is you can build the entire grid, lay down your ballast, run your home runs before you ever touch a module. So lot of our competitors, you need the module to connect the array, but that's not the case with the PRG system. So just understanding the BOM of the PRG. So again, like when you have your layout, we'll give you on the right here, we'll give you your bill of materials. It looks like a lot of components, but it's not, because everything, you know, is set. So, you know, you lay down your rubber mats there. There's an indication there, 5, 10, or 15 degrees, which slot you're going to use to lay down your runner into. Then you'll put your runners. Your runners will set your north-south spacing. So once you've built your first row, basically you're not measuring anything. You're just attaching runners, which will set your north-south spacing. Your crossmember here will set your east-west spacing. And then your clamps, which you snap onto your runners. There's a pre-drilled hole and a dimple which will indicate where you're snapping in your clamps. So there's really no thinking on the roof in terms of, you know, after you've put your string line for your first row and you have the first row set, you're just building. Like there's no more thinking at all, because all the spacing is done for you. And again, you know, this is here is, you know, your south clamp here. You'll see the dimples here on the clamp itself, and that's what bonds your module to the rack. So as long as you have a completely interconnected grid, you need one ground lug per connected array. So again, it's very, very little effort once you get going. As long as you've paid attention on your first row, you're good to go through the rest of the system. At the top here, your module slides into the north clamp, so there's no extra clamp there. And on the south side, you're basically installing an end clamp here, that slides into the slot on your clamp at the bottom, similar to what you would see on a residential installation. So again, very, very simple, very little thought on the roof at all, in terms of assembly, when you're going. And we did have a foot-based system for a short time. Some of you installers that are online have worked with that PRB, and my most frustrating part of that system was watching people square up the array with the modules, and this has taken that out of the equation. This is the ballast placement. So again, something to consider when you're building your array. For 72 degree panels at the higher tilts, we can go up to 12 and 10 and 12 stones. Really only ever see that on extremely high roofs. But for your standard array, which is similar to what you've seen before, you generally won't go over 6 stones in any bay for any assembly, that for 80 or 90% of your roof. So one of the other, again, like I said, polar racking started in the flat roof ballasted business. And what we tried to do when we came up with PRG is to address a lot of the issues that we learned along the way. And that kind of led us to this bent tube design. And one of the main issues that, we found, even though I think, the PR1 and PR2 product was an excellent product, was corner clamping of the modules. And as Danny alluded to earlier, when you're not, when you're not supporting modules in the green zone, you're definitely, or in many cases, you're not getting the full warranty from your module manufacturer. And this is, definitely a huge issue, and especially in Canada where you have heavy wind and heavy snow loads, it's definitely something we wanted to address. And we addressed it through this bent tube design, where, as when you tell us which module you're using, we will make sure that we have the proper east-west spacing so that your north-south runners line up with the green zones of the module manufacturer recommended green zones. So again, that's huge when it comes to building these arrays. These are, you know, 20-year projects, and you definitely want to make sure your module is supported correctly, and that especially if you're selling this to, you know, one of your customers, that their, you know, their module, you know, in 10 years or in 12 years, if they have issues, you know, the first thing that module manufacturers ask, it's their get out of jail free card, is, you know, how are you securing the module? And as soon as, you know, they or you tell the module manufacturer you're supporting in the corners, you know, you're likely to get, you know, a quick hang up, unless, you know, you have a specific letter and they've done specific testing, which, you know, we've had to do in the past, but modules keep changing so quickly, and oftentimes you don't know which module you're ordering until, you know, you're ready to go. So you'll know with the PRG system that the module, you know, that you're going to use is going to be clamped, you know, in, you know, 99.9% of the cases where it needs to be. So we do, even though this is a ballasted racking solution, we do have options for anchoring. And, you know, in some cases it's due to seismic, although in Ottawa right now we're supplying systems without any anchors. But that being said, you know, there's some cases where the roof just has very, very limited capacity, and a small roof or high roofs. We're working on a portfolio of projects right now in Manhattan where it's on residential buildings. The buildings are pretty small footprint. They're very high in the air, and we're doing either all ballasted, all anchored, or hybrid. You know, some anchors and some ballast. Again, the advantage of PRG being a completely interconnected grid is, if for any reason you have to go down that road, we generally have much fewer anchors than you would have on most of the other solutions out there, because it's completely interconnected. There are options for penetrating and non-penetrating. Again, you don't want to go down this road if you don't have to, because it definitely adds extra cost, but it's definitely something that you should consider if you have a roof that has very low capacity, or again, that's very, very high, where you're going to need anchors. Like, this is definitely a solution that, you know, we can offer you. And generally, if you have to go down that road, you're going to get a lot less anchors with PRG than you will with other systems. So. There are also options for optimizer mounting or, you know, end phase mounting as well. It's very, very simple. Again, it's, you know, it bonds the optimizer to the rack. It's very, very simple installation. And basically, you just buy those extra clamps from Frankensolar, and it's pretty, pretty plug and play there. So. Wire management, you know, we do have different wire management options. You know, we've kind of seen people do a little bit of everything. So if you share with us what you're thinking, we might have a solution to make your life a little bit easier. And again, you know, you can buy some extra clamps and brackets through Frankensolar that may or may not make your life a little easier. I know a lot of you are very, very creative out there. So we'll leave that to you to come back to us and let us know what you're thinking. But wanted to share this so you could see that there are many options. In terms of running cables north-south, if need be, you know, you can make a hole in the wind deflector to, you know, run a cable tray through it if required. You know, the only condition being that you just have, if you do make a cutout, that you replace that with something, you know, it's just not an empty cutout. So again, you know, as you go down this road and you're going to have these questions, I want you to know there's options, but ideally, you know, if you're doing something like this, you're speaking with us and we're giving you the green light to do it. So again, some more pictures of wire management because this question comes up a lot and it may have already come up in the chat. Pre-assembly options, so that we've actually encountered three. This is another very unique feature of PRG, is that you can do a lot of assembly on the ground. There's actually three times in the history of PRG that this has happened. Unfortunately, we have pictures of one of them. Keith was
Fortunately, we only have pictures.
Keith was on For many of these, for all three, I think. Basically, in one case, there's too much snow on the roof, and the building that they're building on, they happen to have an empty warehouse inside, and they were able to, again, like build like 1x3, 1x4, 1x5 arrays, and then literally lift them to roof once they were able to clear off the snow and start laying them down. The second time that this happened was it was in Connecticut, and it was they had a heat wave and they were working on EPDM roof, and they just didn't have it was just too hot for them to work on the roof. So they actually built a tent in one corner of the roof. They built their arrays and then they walked them out on site. And then the third option, which I believe is this one, was in Vermont, where they thought they were ready to go and they thought they were getting get a building permit, and something happened to stop their, some delay in the building permit. And rather than sit around and do nothing and waste another 2 weeks until they solve their building permit issues, they just started building arrays. And the other thing you guys should keep in mind, which is not necessarily for pre-assembly, is that you don't need your module to build your grid. Again, you can build this entire grid, put down ballast, run your home runs, and you don't need the module. So, that really helps if, number one, if your modules are delayed for any reason, or two, you can have limited load on the roof at any time. So you want to stagger, because obviously when you're lifting stuff to the roof, it's a lot more concentrated load than when it's all spread out throughout the roof. So if you do have any issues like that, again, you lift the PRG, build the entire grid, lay down your ballast, and then bring the modules afterwards. It could definitely help in those circumstances as well. Certifications and testing, again, ETL listing for, as per UL 2703 for the US and Canada. Wind tunnel study through RWDI, coefficient of friction testing through Exova. We've done finite element analysis and internal load testing, and we can share a lot of the data. Again, this is more if you guys are worried about, independent engineer reviewing the data and they need to see backup and they need to see testing data. Like, we have it all, and we can share it with you, pretty quickly. So. I went quickly so we could answer a lot of questions. Again, if anyone wants us to go backwards and go through some of a
couple questions already.
Okay, yeah. So there's a couple questions. Perfect. Go back through any of the slides. Happy to do that. Danny, I don't know if you have any comments right now before we get into some questions.
No. It's great. I think it's. The other thing too, I wanted to mention that if someone doesn't have my contact information or know how to get in touch with Frankensolar, you can reach, the easiest way is send an email to sales@frankensolar.ca and maybe leave your phone or contact information and we'll reach out to you. In the East, we have a salesperson named Randy. Randy Fascinato, many of you know him already. And then out west, it's Natalie. And she actually joined us from a racking company, from another racking company. So she's very familiar with flat roof racking and all that stuff and what goes into it. So she's super knowledgeable and a great person to have on staff. In general, I want to add too that, Frankensolar looks at, and we look at ourselves as an extension to your business. So, we want to help you be successful and find the right solutions for the systems that you have, and just help you be successful in general. So anything that you need help with, just ask your salesperson from Frankensolar to help you out with, and we gladly do that.
Perfect. So I do have one question here from Jennifer Johnson. It's a good question. You answered your own question here, but she asked, what's included in Frankensolar's cost per panel? Is it everything on that item list, 1 to 14? Obviously, stones and panels are not. So, yeah, you're right about that. Just, going back to the BOM here, Everything is included, the rubber pads, the clamps, everything you see here, with the exception of not the module and not the stones. But yeah, everything else that you see here, 1 to 14, is included. Again, the only other thing you guys would consider when ordering is, like, you know, are you going to have optimizers? Because, you know, then we would need to sell you some clamps to, you know, add your optimizers or end phase inverters, microinverters, or, you know, are you going to use anchors? Then we give you anchor bracket, and we sell the anchors as well. You know, that's pretty much what it's not included here. So,
I'd like to add to that the price that you see on there is the 5 and 10 degree solutions that that Polar has. Doesn't matter if it's the tight or the standard; they're both the same price. If it is, if you would like to go to a 15 degree solution, it is about it's about $10 per panel more, and we will update that on the next price list that's going out either late this week or early, well, either tomorrow or Monday. And then the other thing we'll add to is the optimizer clamp as well. That's additional, and we will add that to the price list for you.
Perfect. George asks, George asks, how is it compared to the EcoFoot? So, George, I mean, that's a really good question. The EcoFoot's a very, very different type of solution. That's a foot-based solution. It's made out of plastic. You know, it's, we had a foot-based solution, and generally with the foot-based solutions, you need more ballast, and you need at least one ballast stone per foot, and you're not clamping in the green zone. So we have seen, you know, the EcoFoot on smaller installs, but it generally, you know, we're not a big fan of foot-based solutions, and that's why we've come up with the grid-based, you know, PRG solution. So
the other difference is cost is a big difference, and I think that's why you don't see too much EcoFoot in Canada anyways on larger systems. Like Vishal said, the ballast requirements are a little bit different. I have nothing bad to say about EcoFoot. It's a very good solution, but it does, you know, it does come at a higher cost, and it may not work everywhere because the ballast requirements are a little bit higher due to it being a foot-based solution.
Field it the way Mark did. So one question here is about the installation speeds, which is probably the most common and the most hated question for myself. So it really, really depends on what you guys have for employees as well as the roof conditions. So I always give one example. Went down, actually did the Connecticut project, and in one day we installed 500 kilowatts of racking. No glass, no wiring, nothing like that. But we did the whole racking, 500 kilowatts in one long day. A few guys that were just tanks, and we went fairly fast, and there's about 6 of us in total. But then I've also seen guys take 2 weeks to install like 20 modules. So it very, very much does depend on the skill and ability of your employees. One thing we normally incorporate well is on the larger projects. In the past, I've been going out and helping with the learning curve to make sure you enjoy the product as much as possible. And that's one thing. It's always the impossible question of how fast can it be installed. The other advantage too is you normally have one crew go in, do all the rack installation. So everything that's all the ballast, they get that all done. Then your electricians can come in behind or start at the other end of the roof, do all that, and then the modules can go on last. So it really allows you to have 3 different skill set crews that can either overlap or not even be there at the same time. And with current conditions, having them not there at the same time is not actually a horrible idea, because you could do all the mechanical connections, have your electricians come in, and then you don't have to have them overlap to worry about the whole COVID situation.
That's a good point. How do we incorporate microinverters, Jennifer? I'm not sure if you saw that slide. So basically, I'll just run back to that. We have this microinverter clamp that again we can supply you, and that works with SolarEdge and Enphase inverters for the most part. I don't know what else, Danny, you're selling right now, and if this would work with that, I'm pretty sure it would. They all have the
AP systems. It would work with AP systems. We also, the single phase Huawei inverters have optimizers, which will work with, and then use Tygo for SMA and Fronius, and that works as well. So it's always kind of the same concept.
Okay, perfect. The pricing is in Canadian dollars.
And it's below, it's significantly below $60 per panel. I don't want to get into details, but you know, check your price list or ask for the price list.
Yeah, sorry, just going back, what anchor solutions are you providing? So we've worked with many different types. In general, U-Anchor has been our default solution because they have a solution that works with many different roof types. It's tested, they've worked with many roofing manufacturers already. And you know, it's competitively priced and it fits well with our system. But if you have another anchor solution that you would like us to look at, you know, we can definitely do that. But you know, generally that one has, they've been the one supplier that we found has been able to give us the widest range of options. Sorry, just going back into the questions here. Any data on solutions? We answered that. Very, very easy to transport. It basically, you get boxes with runners and cross members and wind deflector. We can share some pictures with Frankensolar, and if you guys have questions or you can reach out and we can share some pictures with you on how it's packed. Probably would have been good to have in the presentation. Definitely good note for next time. It definitely works on small residential systems as well. You should still be lighter than other systems, with this systems. And again, with the group clamping, if you're selling this to a residential guy, like you don't want him to know, 10 years from now when he has an issue with the module that the module wasn't clamped the way that the manufacturer wanted it to be clamped, right? So, Ali, price per square foot, it's tough for us to say price per square foot. Typical module, is 2 meters by 1 meters, but then depending on which spacing options you choose, and if you look at, the Frankensolar price list, you can come up with a rough number, but generally we quote it price per module, you can go, you can do, the reverse math from there, based on the module size and the spacing and the tilt angle you've chosen. So, system has inter-row spacing. Yes. So if you download our data sheet from our website, it's here in the presentation as well, but the data sheet from our website, you will see the five different inter-row spacing options. So again, 5 degree tighter, 5 degree standard, and it gives you, your row-to-row distance and your module-to-module distance. As I said, in Canada, we've been selling mostly 10 degree tighter. In the US, lots and lots of 5 degree tighter. But again, the 15 degree option is there in case you want some additional additional production and you have the space for it. So
one other nice thing I'd like to add about the Polar PRG is that the ballast actually goes underneath the solar panel. So your walkways between the rows is actually a little bit you know, you have a lot of, you have a fair amount of space there, even if it is tight, to walk through. You don't have to step over ballast blocks and things like that, which can be the trip hazard, obviously, and some building owners really don't like it. So I think it's important to point that out.
Okay, can you show the page? Can you show the information required for design again? Yes, we can. So we actually prepared something for Frankensolar today to send to them. So if you contact them, they can actually send this out to you, the project intake form. But since we're here, seeing this. Danny, are you seeing the screen moving again?
No, you're still on. You're on the multiple tilt and spacing option slide.
Zoom slideshow there.
Yeah, it's working again. So, yeah, I mean, it's standard. You know, the project size again. Sometimes you have a lot of roof space, but you know, you only need 40 kilowatts there because that's what the program is in that area. And or you know, you can tell us to max it out, which we can do. The module dimensions, data sheet. You know, we always ask for the data sheet when we're getting, you know, when we get an order. You know, the great thing about working with Frankensolar is they have extremely competitive pricing on modules as well that pair very well with our system, and they can ship it to you all together. So, you know, that's obviously something that you want to talk to them about. Tilt angle, again, 5, 10, 15 degrees, which angle you want, which row option spacing you want, you know, a layout of the roof, building heights, you know, all pretty standard stuff. Yeah, let me know if you have any other questions here. So. You mentioned tested for mechanical load. What's the max snow load? So we tested it to 2.4 kPa, which, you know, our UL certification is to 2.4 kPa, I should say, which is 50 PSF. We have tested it to much higher loads. And, you know, so you ask about 65, 70 PSF, like we've tested it to that. It's, you know, it's past it, but it's not third party, you know, verified, you know, as per our UL, but you know, it has worked. So, yeah, ballast is hidden. Yeah, George. Yeah. That, thank you, Danny, for bringing that up. That is a good point there. So, sorry, Danny, I just saw your message. So I should point out that the ballast goes underneath the module.
Better late than never.
Yeah, so thank you for pointing that out. And that's it for the questions. If anyone wants to make any comments, you can put your hand up. It's next to the chat, and I can unmute your microphone. And you know, if you have any questions or comments, or would like to speak about something, you know, on the call, happy to have you join. And if not, again, the team from Frankensolar or myself are available to answer any questions. So
awesome. I think that just about wraps it up. Thank you very much, Vishal, for you know, telling us a little bit more about PRG, and definitely it is really, really easy to quote this stuff, and you can take that number on our price list to the bank. It is, you know, it is very competitive, and we are very confident in the price, so there will be no surprises after the fact. So yeah, if you're bidding on an RFP or you know, bidding for a quote, you really don't have to, you know, do a layout necessarily. The only thing that gets affected by the layout is the ballast. So obviously, you know, take into account a little bit of a buffer for a little bit of ballast, but we're very confident in the price.
Yeah, I think Lewis had a question. Can you unmute your microphone, Lewis? Sorry, and you can ask. Or maybe he was just testing the wave feature. I'm not sure.
Hey, I'm sorry, it was just a mistake. I was testing the feature there.
Okay. Well, no, that's fine. So, yeah, again, yeah, thank you, Danny, for organizing this with us. We really appreciate it. We appreciate the partnership that we have with Frankensolar, so definitely thank you for that. And if anyone has any questions, feel free to reach out to the team from Polar or the team from Frankensolar, and we'll go ahead. As I said, we've been doing flat ballasted rooftops for a very long time, and we feel like this product really answers a lot of questions, you know, that we've been getting from the beginning, which is, you know, low ballast, green zone clamping, modular design, and very, very simple assembly, you know, not much thinking on the roof. And we have the UL certifications, which many other people in Canada don't have. So hopefully you've appreciated that. Looking forward to seeing opportunities from everyone. Sorry, George just asked a question. I missed some pricing. I think George wants to get some pricing. How do I quote on a residential? I suspect per module. Yeah, exactly. You just Frankensolar site, you can grab their price list and if you have 20 modules, it'll be simple enough for you to get a quote on that. So 20, 40, 50, whatever it is. So 5,000.
Awesome. Thank you guys very much.
Yeah. Thank you very much, guys. Really, really appreciate your time and for you to join. Hopefully everybody's staying safe and we're looking forward to connecting with everybody soon.
Bye.
Take care. Bye.